Today we have really good news for Israel. It's now producing more of its own energy, and it soon may be a major energy producer for the whole Middle East.
Israel's able to do all of this because of a major underwater development of natural gas. Chris Mitchell has the story.
4 years after its discovery, the Tamar Reservoir began supplying Israel with natural gas from the Mediterranean Sea that will fuel its electric power plants.
From now on, Israel can provide its needs for the next decades.
The Tamar field is located about 60 miles off the coast of Haifa. Energy and Water Minister Silvan Shalom declared it a day of energy independence.
It's much cheaper, and of course, it's much cleaner. And from now on, the whole energy market will save at least 1 billion shekels every month. It means about $300 million every month.
That savings begins in the Mediterranean and then makes its way here. The natural gas flows through an underwater pipeline for about 100 miles to a platform off the coast here near the Israeli port of Ashdod. It's predicted that Tamar wells could eventually produce more than 4 times the energy value of Saudi Arabian wells.
Natural gas is a very good companion, in a sense, to solar, and that could help make Israel very independent and, I think, secure with respect to its electricity generation, not needing to import anything.
Before the fall of the Mubarak regime, Egypt supplied about half of Israel's natural gas needs. Afterward, extremists blew up the pipeline almost continuously. That led to the permanent cutoff of the supply.
The latest events in the region, not just in Egypt, only enhanced the feel that we need to rely on our own resources.
Still, some experts say there are risks involved.
Imagine that in 2 years' time, 70% of the electricity, most of the fuel for industry and for transportation and other uses is going to be based on gas from one field, which is subject to strategic threat, a threat of missiles attacks.
Former CIA chief and energy expert James Woolsey told CBN News the fields represent a strategic advantage for Israel.
Israel's certainly a lot better off in terms of their energy independence from having found these gas fields.
An even larger gas field called Leviathan is expected to come online in 3 years. That reservoir is expected to take Israel from not only energy independence, but to an energy exporter. Chris Mitchell, CBN News, Ashdod, Israel.
Wonderful names for these various fields, but just imagine what it does, not just for Israel, but also for Europe. If there can be a pipeline from that Leviathan field, it now removes the monopoly that Russia has on supplying Europe with natural gas. This is a tremendous development and will have long-ranging repercussions for the whole region. Well, here at home, senators from both parties have reached an important agreement on a major political issue. Lee Webb has that story from the CBN newsroom. Lee?
Gordon, that's right. A bipartisan group of senators has agreed to add stronger border security to a new immigration reform bill. That measure calls for surveillance of the entire U.S. border with Mexico. It also calls for the capture of 90% of people trying to cross at certain high-risk areas. Illegal immigrants would be able to get green cards in 10 years, but only if the new southern border security plan is in place. The move comes as a growing number of conservative evangelical leaders have said they support immigration reform. The state of Delaware is investigating the Planned Parenthood abortion clinic in Wilmington. Two nurses there claim the clinic is operating under unsanitary and unsafe conditions. They tell Philadelphia's ABC television affiliate that they quit the clinic to protect their own medical licenses. They said the clinic uses unsterilized instruments. They also claim that patients are rushed in and out, leaving operating tables soiled and unclean. They call it a meat market style of assembly line abortions. One nurse worrying that she would be held liable if a patient was hurt. Delaware officials do not inspect abortion clinics in that state routinely. Delaware Planned Parenthood, though, claims it provides high-quality services, but admits it is reviewing its patient care. Wild weather in the nation's Midwest. Powerful storms packing rain, snow, and wind move through the region. The system spawned at least 3 tornadoes across Missouri Wednesday night. And all of that led the governor to declare a state of emergency. In Arkansas, people are picking up the pieces after severe storms destroyed 6 homes. And in Minnesota, snow. Forecasters are calling for as much as 14 inches in parts of the state 3 weeks into spring. Some worry snow could also cause problems in southeastern North Dakota, an area prone to flooding. Well, the IRS believes it can read your email without a search warrant. IRS lawyers have written in documents that Americans don't have privacy rights in their emails or other online messages. The American Civil Liberties Union obtained those IRS documents, and it believes that position is at odds with the 4th Amendment of the U.S. Constitution. It says people are free from unreasonable searches and seizures. A federal court ruled 2 years ago that Americans do have a right to privacy in their emails, but the IRS has not changed its policies, Gordon, about searching emails without a warrant.
Lee, the fascinating thing about this is that the IRS has taken the position that American citizens have no reasonable expectation of privacy in any email. I would posit it as an extreme position, but that's the position they've taken. And what it means is they have access and can read your emails without obtaining a warrant. That is Big Brother peering over your shoulder, literally looking at what you're typing into your computer. And I find that just absolutely incredible. We certainly need to get legislation passed that you need a warrant before you can look at the email files. But apparently the IRS has been routinely going for Google and Yahoo and these other services, saying we need access to these email accounts. And if that's happening, you just sort of shake your head. One word of warning. I do know that the Attorney General under the Bush administration had it as a policy that he had no email accounts. He never put anything into an email. And so that tells you the level of security. Once these things are written and put onto servers, you do lose control over it. And then that's probably why the IRS is saying no one can have a reasonable expectation of privacy. But I know for me, Terry, when I send them, I think they're...
Absolutely.
I think they're kind of like a letter, so...
The presumption of that is just astonishing, really. Where do you think that's going? Are we going to do something about that?
I think a lot of it has to do with what's been rolled back in terms of the Patriot Act, where we're trying to stop terrorism, and so therefore electronic surveillance is way on the rise, and the IRS is just coming alongside that. But the days of telephone wiretaps, you need a warrant. The days of if you're going to open their mail, you need a warrant. The days of, if you're going to come into the home, you need a warrant. More and more we do things online, and if the government takes the position there's no reasonable expectation of privacy there, well, then we need legislation to solve it.
Boy, you could see a mass exodus from some of that pretty quickly.
The Washington State Attorney General is suing a florist for refusing to provide flowers for a gay wedding. Baronelle Stutzman owns Arlene's Flowers in Richland. She objected to selling a gay customer flowers for his same-sex wedding because of her Christian faith. The state attorney general filed a consumer protection suit against Stutzman. He argues she discriminated against the customer based on his sexual orientation. Stutzman's attorney says the case is not about discrimination, but rather freedom of speech and religion. Well, the U.S. Postal Service will continue Saturday mail delivery after all. That despite announcing plans to cut back to a 5-day-a-week delivery system. The USPS says the reversal comes because Congress failed to drop a longtime spending measure that prohibits reduced delivery days. The Postal Service Board says it's not possible to meet its goals for reducing spending without altering the delivery schedule. They say Congress is delaying what they call, quote, responsible change. Remember, you can always get the latest from CBN News by going to our website at cbnnews.com.